How you doing? You a little rattled this morning, honey? You know, just slightly. Here we go. No lyrics. Great. I get a rattle every time we meet. I get a rattle deep down in my feet. Well, I get rattled, baby. Over you. Hey, Maisie. I get a rattle something in my soul. I get a rattle then I'm out of control. I get rattled, baby. Hi, Roy. Over you. Hi, Tommy. Hi, Bob. Hi, Jeff. Oh, baby, 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 won't you stay for that? Short shrift! Baby, 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 is there something wrong with you? Baby, 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 this is out of my control. It looks like something's wrong, but way deep down in my soul. Rattled. Twisted. Shaking. Hi, George. Rattled. I guess. Twisted, baby. All of you. Bam, 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 bam. Ray George. Doing his best Carl Perkins. Hey, Carl. I get twisted, baby. Over you. Meow, 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 meow. Oh, baby, 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 won't you play one dance for me? Baby, 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 is there something wrong with you? Oh, baby, 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 this is out of my control. It looks like something's wrong, but way deep down in my soul. Rattled, twisted, shaking, rattled, rolling. Twisted, baby, over you. I gotta get wretched, I get drowned up by the roots, oh boy. Baby, baby, is there nothing I can do? Well, I get rattled, baby, over you. Yeah, I get rattled, baby. Over you. Ooh, I get rattled, baby. Over you. Where's my bell? Boy, so this is going to be one of those insane kind of days. Yeah. Could say that. Everybody seems a little rattled this morning. Yeah. Yeah, the big guy in there's got his balls all twisted up. Oh, God. It's great when you wake up and he's got his balls all twisted up in a knot and he's fucking yelling at you like a fucking banshee. I wonder what he's got going today. Maybe he has to do something else for his mother. I tell you, surrounded by men my whole life that for one reason or another, I kind of depend on them, but I've had it. I've had it. I don't want to put up with this fucking crap. I don't want to talk to him. I don't want to know men. Oh boy, what a thing to say to me. No, you're not men. You're John. Oh, thanks, Bubby. Thank you. Today our card was the Hierophant, 7:56 a.m. reading. It was a great reading that we did. Encouraging people not to neglect spiritual practice. Make a ritual. You know, we said, it just map out 15 minutes a day. You'll get addicted to it and you'll want to do it more. But do your deep breathing and, well, we'll get into that later, John, okay? Yeah. Okay, because I interrupted Christopher's ritual. Is that what it is? Is that because he listens to the news every morning? And that's right. You interrupted his meditation with your needs. Look, what do you want me to do? Just be aware of it. It throws him for a loop. He has that habit every morning. And you usually don't really bother him, but you needed him this morning for something. quite validly so, but you interrupted his ritual, so his balls got twisted. He doesn't handle it well. When he interrupts your meditation, and it happens pretty often, no, he's actually gotten much better with that. Okay, so let's start the day on a new foot. All right. And let him sit there and let his balls untwist, and we'll work it out from there. How's that? Yeah, that's a good idea. Can all be worked out. And you know, Brian, a simple apology to Lena, Brian out there, you know, a simple apology from you would go a long way, but none of you guys seem capable of that ever. That's a sad thing. You, your buddy Pete Terry, your nasty little witch friend Alma. Hey, I got two words for Alma. Cancer. When you got a lot of hang-ups and you're very, very, you know, deeply have inner darkness, that manifests in cancer. Often in young people where that wouldn't usually happen. Well, Chris got cancer pretty young. Yeah, he's got a lot of inner darkness. He's got a lot of inner demons. We pulled him out of it, but his cancer, you know, a man his age shouldn't have had stage 4 colon and liver cancer. And when you have a lot of inner work that you're not addressing, meaning your spiritual side, that builds up in dark energy, which manifests in the form of cancer. Yes, cancer is a manifestation of the human condition. So yeah, out there. Now, when you got the nasties on the inside, you literally get the nasties really bad until you can see it on the outside.
Right.
That's fucked up. I get twisted, baby. Well, let's see what else we got. Let's do some more Wellberries this morning. All right. Sounds great. But let me just elaborate on the Hierophant. Hi, Hierophant. Hi, Mom and Dad. Good morning. We love you. Show us how best to serve you. I feel that we're on the good foot right now. Things got better. Things go better with Coke. Yeah. Or a little caffeine anyway. Yeah, we're having a little matcha tea. And that's got good caffeine in it. Good caffeine. There is good caffeine. Mm-hmm. There's a way to enjoy caffeine in moderation that you don't go insane. So it's we encouraged starting of, you know, a spiritual practice of 15 minutes a day where you breathe deep, clear your mind. You can think of things that you're grateful for and jot them down every day. You'll come up with something different every day. Every day I say I'm grateful for my body and my arms and legs and my ability to see and hear and speak. That's always on the forefront, and I reinforce that every day because I don't want to lose those things. And if you're not grateful for your gifts, they will leave you at some point. Not guaranteed, but it's better to show gratitude, and not out of fear, but out of genuine gratitude. Be happy. Look around you. Look at all the beautiful things you can see and feel and hear. Aren't you grateful for those things? Wouldn't it be lesser life if you were to be in silence, utter silence, or utter darkness, and not be able to feel, not be able to use your hands, not be able to walk, not be able to talk, express yourself? Aren't you grateful for those things? Why not? You should be. And then other things will come. I'm grateful for animals. I'm grateful for my friends. I'm grateful for my family. I'm grateful for art. I'm grateful for, yeah, art. Art is amazing. Grateful for great food. Creativity to make that food. I'm grateful to be able to help people and animals and do things to make the world a better place. I'm grateful that I have those opportunities. The list can just grow and grow. So another good thing to do is to make a vision board. And I used to advise people on to make vision boards all the time. And of things that they want, and you just cut, you know, a simplest form of the vision board is you cut pictures out of a magazine, and that's what I used to do. Put them up on a bulletin board, and just like people riding horses and couples kissing and all kinds of things, beautiful faraway places and animals and more animals, and just, you never put me on the vision board. You were the vision board. Lena, I'm going to cry. Don't cry. Hold on, I need a tissue. So yeah, we're in horrible tears right now.
Horrible.
Horrible tears. This tea, I'm grateful for this wonderful tea. And these great cups. And this symbol, which is a symbol of love. But you know, this is the way everybody should approach life. From that angle of gratitude, and then everything else will be that. John, my God. Oh, God. Okay. I wandered all around with nothing more than time on my hands. I was lost in the night with no sight of you. And at times it was so blue and lonely, heading for the light. Been close to the edge, hanging by my fingers.